guys, today I'm going to show how to update database record using HTML form in PHP. So let's start it. The first update the database name class and the table class info. So you can see the list of class information, which is room number, first name, last name, email, and phone number. They are already inserted in the local post. So we can implement this program. We can continue implement this program by creating three files, which is the first file is search.html, the second file is search.php, and the third file is update.php. So at the search.html file, I want to search the room number. So it contains user interface which allows user to enter room number and display its record. So in order to search the number, I create a form that has three attributes. The first attribute is name form 1. The second attribute method post. And the third attribute is action search.php, which will display the guest information. So inside the form text, I want to create a text box. So I type input name T1, type text for text box, and input name S1, type submit for submit button. So this HTML code is for creating user interface. So at the search.php, I start with create a PHP code. So the first thing I do is I connect my database connection, and then I create a variable $f equal to $_post_t1, which is it fetch my form data that is room number, and then I create a variable sq for query to select star from guest info where room number equal to $f, and then I create a $table variable so that when this query does it with the number of record, they have the variable to store this record in the $table. So my SQLi underscore query that have two parameters. The first parameter consists of connection variable name that is $db, and the second parameter is a query which is $sq. So think of my SQLi underscore fetch underscore array is to fetch a result row as an associative array, a numeric array, or both. The reason why I create the $row is when we call this function, which is row table, it will return single record. So therefore we have to store it into variable $row. After that I create 5 variables, which is the name of field that is created at the database table. We have the room number, first number, last name, email number, and phone number. So I create a variable for room number $R, first name $F, last name $L, email $E, and phone number $P. That's all for the PHP code. Next, for the HTML code, I want to create a form, just like before, but it consists of all information, all guest information that is room number, first name, last name, email, and phone number. So it contains three attributes, name, form 1, method post, action, update.php. Update.php is a very important file because it is responsible for updating record use in form. So inside the form, we want to create a user interface for display a record. So start with room number, input name T1, type text value, and then we put the PHP code inside the value. And the reason why I type read only is because the user cannot modify attribute the value of room number. And then we do the same thing for the first name, last name, email, phone number. And we change the T1 to T2, T3, T4, and T5.
So the value attribute, I use the PHP code. And then the next thing I do is I click the empty button, which is the equipment if there's one type something to do update. So for update the PHP, the first thing we have to connect our database space, and then we fetch this T1, T2, T3, T4, and T5 from the search.php. T1, T2, T3, T4, and T5. And then I create an update query named $UP, which is update test info set first name $F, last name $L, email $E, phone number $P, where room number is $R. I used to set keyword is the function will return two value, either positive or negative, and it will store the status of the function into the variable $S. So MySQLi underscore query function that have two parameters. The first parameter is the database connection, which is $db, and the second parameter is query, which is $UP. So if $S is success, so MySQL will return 1, equal record update successfully. Else, otherwise we return 0, equal error please check value. So let's have a try at the local host. So we want to try our file at the local host. So let's say I want to use the room number 1003. So we type localhost / host file is search.html, and then room number 1003. Click submit, and you see the list of guest information, room number 1003, first name,
number is changed to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So our program is successful. So thank you for watching my video.